What's going on, y'all? It is your favorite Auntie Mo. And we are back for another episode review. This is Love & Hip Hop Miami, Season 3, Episode 2. I forgot the doggone name of it. I'm going to have it up here somewhere. I'm sorry. Players fuck up. I forgot. My bad. Church announcements, as always. Before we get into the review, if y'all have not done so just yet, go ahead and subscribe to your Auntie channel. Now, if you are new to my channel, welcome. I'm your favorite crap talking auntie here to give you the best unsolicited commentary on some of your favorite reality shows and other stuff like that. Here and there, I might do a little mukbang, might vlog a little bit. Just depending on what my mood felt like. You know, I'm a little bipolar, so whatever the wind takes me, that's where I'm gonna go. Okay. Also, before you leave, let me know that you stop by. Okay, give me a thumbs up or thumbs down, whichever one. As long as you let me know that you stop by, okay? And then hit the notification bell so you will know. Boop. Auntie got some new shit uploaded. Let me go ahead and check on over to her channel, see what she got going on, okay? Y'all, this episode was kind of boring. I'm not gonna lie, but you know I'm gonna give it to you good. I'm sipping on a little water today. You know, I slipped up this weekend because I filmed a mukbang or whatever, and it was off the chain, so I had some corn. So now I'm back on my strict keto until I fall back off the wagon again this weekend, because I'm gonna film another mukbang. But that ain't none of your business. I just feel like you needed to know. But hopefully y'all are ready for this review, because I'm ready to give it to you. So let's go ahead and get right on up into it. All right, y'all. So I got the Exorcist on, and this movie was thrown. How did I watch this as a kid? Mama, why did you let me watch this as a kid? This shit is crazy. But the episode starts off with Amara La Negra. She's talking with her boyfriend, MJ, about everything that happened the night before her event with her and Shay, and how Shay was just doing the most, and the night was supposed to be about Amara, and she made it all about herself, and not all everybody's gonna remember is what happened from the night before. Y'all know I love me some Amara. Pause for the cause. Can we just say Amara's skin is beautiful? Girl, it looks like the finest and the most beautiful as of the blackest oak of mahogany beautiness. Girl, you must drink a lot of water and use a lot of cocoa butter and a lot of Vaseline, because she's beautiful and she's greasy and she's flawless. Beautiful. But you know, she's talking with MJ about everything that happened the night before, and MJ's whole thing is, look here, I felt like both of y'all, you know, kind of did the most. Yes, you should have let her know that, you know, this chick that you got an issue with gonna be here tonight. We all know that you're sensitive, so before you get to popping off and all of that, just know she coming. I ain't saying I'm making up and finna be friends with the bitch. I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying, she gonna be here. Bitch don't trip. But Amara's whole thing is, look, she could have just said, I'm upset, I don't even want to be here right now, but I'm going to talk to you about it later. But she didn't have to do everything that she did, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, they talking about the whole thing. Look at y'all, look, if y'all ain't learned by now, Bucky is sensitive. Yes, you know, that was Amara's thing. I felt like, you know, Amara probably should have let Bucky know too, because y'all know, like I said, Bucky's a little sensitive, you know what I'm saying? So you're gonna have to let her know, get that bitch a heads up, what's going on, because she's gonna be that one family member that's gonna act the damn fool at the funeral or at the family reunion or something like that. So that's the type of bitch you gotta give her a heads up. So I felt like, yes, you should have got that bitch a heads up. I'm just saying. Then they get to talking about the whole situation with Julian and how it's a rumor that he done stole $300,000 from Trina. Now, Amara is like, you know, I'm gonna have to have a conversation with him about it later, because I trust him as my manager and I just don't want nothing bad to happen. Now, MJ, her boyfriend, like, look here, you know what I'm saying? Don't let that old scam ass nigga come around here trying to scam you for what you got. I'm already trying to scam your ass. He ain't say all that. You know what I'm saying? You never know, though. But she's going to have a little conversation with him about it later to see exactly what's going on, because I just don't like all of this. Y'all, we got Briscoe straight up out the pen for 10. Ready to get up here, brought this bitch, get it in. Oh, I rap just like an old lady, too. That's all right, though. Your auntie got bars, though. He said he was locked up for 3 years for credit card fraud and for making counterfeit notes. And I was like, well, he ain't talking about car notes and he ain't talking about school notes. Like Benji's? Like hundreds? How was you doing that? Not saying that I don't do illegal shit no more. And I'm not even asking for me. I'm asking for a friend. Like, how you do that? And you know what I'm saying? We're going to move on from that or whatever. He at the radio station talking, trying to promote his new album that he got out. You know what I'm saying? He at the radio station with his son, Lil Briscoe. He say Lil Briscoe up in there dripping. Look here, Briscoe. You was just saying how the mistakes you made in the past got you to where you was. You was in the pen for 10, you know, minus 7. So you did 3 years or whatever. Don't say Lil Briscoe up in here dripping. Unless he's dripping in some books, he dripping in some math problems or something. We don't want our babies to be dripping at 15, 16, unless they dripping with that knowledge. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, I just dropped a word on y'all. Dripping with that knowledge. Stay woke on the ass. Y'all, we got Trina going over here and talking with Trick Daddy. They over there chopping it up in his restaurant, right? He was doing it up in that little restaurant, baby. He said, you want something to eat? I got some fried chops and some fries back here. I was like, ooh, I want some fried chops and some fries. I know Trick Daddy got that grandma neck. Anybody with that grandma neck that's like this, they go and they bigger up here than they are down there. That nigga go hard in the paint on frying some shit. I bullshit you not. If you got an Annie, ain't Bertha, ain't Charlene, ain't Pam, ain't Debbie, ain't any of them, if they got like an army, oh, don't let them have army. Baby, if they got army with all them chins, they go hard in the paint in the kitchen. That's all I'm saying. Tell me I'm lying. They in there chopping up about what happened the night before when Trina seen Julian. Trick Daddy was like, you know, my homeboy Cardi ready to drop a dime on this nigga. Just say the word. Let me know. You know, rock-a-bye, baby. We take this nigga out. Trina like, hold on. Don't send the goons out just yet. You know what I'm saying? We gonna let the nigga breathe for a little bit longer. Her whole thing is she done had everything else going on. With her mama passing away and all of this, she wasn't even worried about going off on a nigga that night. And plus, like she said, she wasn't even there for that. You know what I'm saying? So she tells Trick that she wants to have an all-girls, like, tour, you know, showcase kind of thing going on. And she wants to audition some of the hottest rappers from Miami, the local talent, this, that, and the other, right? Here go Trick. Let my girl Nikki audition. You know what I'm saying? She got talent. You know what I'm saying? She good. Trina like, look here. I done already heard this little bitch got a lot of lip. And I don't want to have to pop her in all them lips. She come at, you know what I'm saying? She come in there respectful. You know what I'm saying? She audition like everybody else. You know, we gonna be good. Trick Daddy co-signing for her. And you know what I'm saying? I was like, okay, you know what I'm saying? Trick Daddy done had a little pep talk, you know, talk with the baby before you send him in there to school. Look here, you still go in the store. Look here. I done co-signed for your ass. Now, don't go in here and don't embarrass me. My name is on your ass. All right? So Trina's holding her auditions at the strip club, right? Where else is we going to hold auditions for some of the baddest, ratchetest chicks that Miami-Dade County got to offer, you know what I'm saying? Because that's the type of artist that Trina's looking for. She says she wants the ratchetest, gutter chicks, all of that. And you know, your auntie got a little ratchet in her, so I was like, oh, yeah, I'm saying, let me see what my bitches is finna get up in there and do, right? Okay, now, first girl that rapped, I was like, oh, okay. She got a couple bars or whatever. And then the other ones got up there. I was like, oh, wow. And then the two girls, did y'all see the two girls, the little duo? What the fuck was going on with that? I mean, you know what? You know what? You know what? They got up there, they did their thing. They little thing. But they just wasn't ready. I bet they was like, you know what, bitch? They told us we can go on stage. Fifi, we finna go on stage and we about to mash these hoes. We ain't gotta practice, bitch. We practice in the car every day. You know what I'm saying? What? And they got on that stage and they made a goddamn fool of themselves. Trina was like, oh no, baby. This ain't where you practice. This where you come to audition. Then Nicki Natural got out there, right? Now, I will say, this is my opinion. Listen here. Let me let you know. Don't nobody come for me because I ain't sent for you. If you ain't getting no package with your name on it from Auntie, I ain't sent for you. So don't come for me. This just my opinion on my platform. Okay? Now, I felt like Nicki had a lot more theatrics than she had lyrics. You know what I'm saying? Like, because she was so theatrical with it and she was, you know what I'm saying? And I, woo, like Top Gun or Top Flight, whatever she said. I was like, oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? She got something going for her. But then I was like, if she'd have just stayed still in the middle of the stage, you know what I'm saying? Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Spit a little thug thizz, you know what I'm saying? I'd have understood her a lot better and got where she was coming from. But she was just doing the most and I couldn't really get it. But she was okay. Next, this chick named J Diva performed. And I thought J Diva was good. Love and Gossip. Oh, I just got a notification. Y'all, my girl Love and Gossip. Love and Gossip Lounge is going live. If y'all don't follow Love and Gossip, that's my bitch from Texas. Shout out to Love and Gossip. She from Dallas, Texas. I'm from Austin, Texas. Tejas and his bitch. Let me stop. I'm getting all off subject. That's my ADD. Focus, Auntie. Focus. Here we go. So, next, J Diva performed. J Diva did good. I liked her. I feel like she needs the right shot. The right opportunity, the right person see her. Oh, that little heifer gonna go somewhere. She looked good. She had like a fun, like little bubbliness to her. But yes, she was gutter and hood. You know what I'm saying? She'll fight you in her Sunday's best. You know what I'm saying? But she'll pray for you all at the same time. She looked like that. Like she, you know what I'm saying? I liked her. She seemed cool to me. Bitch, give her the shot. Next, y'all, was my... Now, look here. Before anybody say anything, I love me some goddamn Sukiyana. I love the hell out of Sukiyana. She's ghetto. She's so ratchet. She's so hood. And she don't give a damn. She will find you the darkest part of her ass to kiss while she's getting it done. She don't give a damn. And I love that about her. Baby, she came out, had her troops ready, got on that damn stage with a cat suit on and her hat, and she was ready. She was the only one they showed that had dancers, had like a whole theme going, had a DJ with music and all that. Bitch, Suki didn't come to play with them. She came in there straight goddamn ready, and I loved it. That shit was hilarious. And of course, Trina loved it, and she was like, you know, of course, you know, bitch, you win. You win. We gonna see you on tour. Take your little ratchet ass on somewhere, bitch. We gonna see you later. So afterwards, Trina asks that, she said that she want J Diva and Nicki Natural to kind of battle, something about, you know, see who's gonna be the last ones. That I don't know why Nicki Natural was in her feelings, but I don't know if maybe she couldn't come up with them bars off the dome like that, and so she wasn't ready for that kind of heat, but... What you call it, asked her, you know, to rap battle, go back and forth. She was like, nah, she not finna do that. She done already won. She not finna do that. Da-da. Bitch just started getting real disrespectful with Trina. Next thing you know, J Diva was ready. J Diva was like, look here, give me the mic. My name is Peaches and I'm the best. All the DJs want to film. She was ready. She came out there ready. Then homegirl goes and grabs the mic from J Diva. I'm like, oh, disrespectful, bitch. Then she tries to yell on the mic. Trina goes and grabs the mic. Trina's like, look here, bitch, this my shit. I'm the queen of Miami. Dip, dip. She goes, tries to grab the mic from Trina. I was like, oh, real disrespectful, bitch. Then she goes to the doggone DJ booth, tells the DJ to cut, DJ Direct, cut the mic. Why the little girl is rapping. And this must have been Mona's DJ. That couldn't have been Trina's DJ that's just going to cut the mic off like that because this little girl told you to cut the mic off. Who paying you? You know, he must be in, he's in Mona's paycheck. He not getting the paycheck through the rest of them. That's just my opinion though, because nigga just gonna cut the mic like that. And on Trina too, they start going back and forth. Trina was cool on her ass. She could have went completely left on her ass. Like, I felt like she should have went on her ass, but she didn't. She was cool on her ass. Baby, in the end, Trina was like, you know, when you go back, how about you tell your ass back on the Trick and you tell Trick about how you lost. If she'd have humbled herself, humbled thine self, Trina would have probably gave her ass a chance, because Trina was actually digging her. It wasn't until she started doing all this here that got her ass caught up. In the end, she ended up leaving looking like a broke dick dog with a little leg between the tail between the legs, running on up out of there. And then what you got? You ain't got shit. Afterwards, girl, Trick is in the studio with Chaotic. Y'all love me some goddamn Chaotic. Y'all know I love the Ratchets. I love the Ratchets. Love the Ratchets. Ooh, your auntie is some god. I'm so goddamn ghetto. Anyways, he in the studio with Chaotic. Trick is telling Chaotic about everything that went on at Trina's performance with his little da-da-da-da Nicki Natural. As they talking, the little da-da-da-da Nicki Natural comes walking in, baby, in a glittery sequency type thing of onesie, looking like she fresh off after school care. With a little juice box and some goddamn goldfish in her hands or something. Ooh, I'm knocking shit over. She goes over there trying to talk to Trick. Like, she trying to rub on him and kiss on him and all that. Trick like, girl, I'm gonna sit your little ground and sit down. We need to goddamn talk. Trick is asking her, like, what the hell happened at this damn showcase? Like, how you gonna disrespect the one female you striving to be like? You can't come in being disrespectful, thinking that motherfuckers just gonna give you a chance like that. Then she starts to once again start being disrespectful about Trina. Well, her last album was trash. I mean, I like Trina, but her last album didn't do too good. Like, Trick Daddy was like, nigga, her last album did better than your non-album on the non-top 100 charts. You ain't even got no damn album. How you gonna say how somebody else's album did? And you trying to get a damn album? Like, she was just doing the most. Then she starts asking him about Joy and what's going on with their divorce and why they still married. I was with Trick. He was like, baby, look here. You need to stay in a child's place. Now, this grown folk business over here. You don't need to worry about what's... You stay in the young ass right there. Don't worry about what's going on here. He needs to get her little ass in check. I don't know if you need to go and buy her some new nail polish colors or take her to McDonald's and get her Happy Meal or something, because she doing the most. Y'all, next we had Amada met up with Trina, and she's just basically getting Trina's side about everything that's going on. And Trina's like, basically, look here, you're going to have to get you a new manager, because by the time I'm done with his ass, I'm going to chew him up, I'm going to spit him out, and ain't nobody else going to want nothing to do with his ass, nothing to deal with his ass. Because Trina breaks it down to her about what the hell is going on. This is why I got an issue with this man, because he done stole 300 racks from me, and I'm trying to get up in that ass. Amada's still torn because she loves Julian like he's her family, and she doesn't know what to do, so she's gonna have to talk with Julian later to like see what's going on with like the whole situation. I'm like, girl, look here, like Trina said, you don't see that, don't nobody else want to work with him? It's signs. And like Amada said, her music and her you know, her career really ain't been going nowhere. So now she's kind of torn, because now it's all these rumors that's coming out about him. Girl, look at the signs, girl. Trick and Trina go see Jocelyn Hernandez, baby. Yes, the Puerto Rican princess is back. They went on like this little boat and had like little cocktails or whatever with Jocelyn and her boyfriend. What was it? Ballistic. That's what his name was. He's cool. I'm like, ew. I mean, I ain't even really into light skins like them. I was like, ew, he's kind of cute. I can't, like, whatever. Apparently, Trick Daddy and Ballistic used to be in some kind of off-brand Viagra pill company back in the day. That's how they know each other. They cool. Nigga, y'all was out here selling horse pills. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Get it how you live. Because I know you made a killing off that shit, for real. Justin is saying that, you know, she's grown up a lot and how, you know, moving away from Atlanta was, it was very toxic for her. And so since she's been in Miami, you know, she's been able to refocus, get all her shit together. Now that she's got this new man in her life, you know, her daughter loves her. I mean, her daughter loves him. He loves her daughter and they just want big ass happy family and shit, whatever, right? So, Trina tells Jocelyn about the whole situation that happened at the showcase and about how Nicki Natural was acting damn fool. Even Jocelyn Hernandez, baby, she even said, how you gonna disrespect the queen? Everybody know Trina is the queen of Miami. I mean, this is just what it is. It's just what it is. That's just what it is. And she was disrespecting her. And I appreciate Jocelyn. Even Jocelyn, you know, now she considers herself to be an old school bitch. She's like, because, you know, she's going to be schooling these young bitches in Jocelyn Hernandez Cabaret, which I will be bringing the review to you. I think it come on this Sunday, if I'm not mistaken. Either way, go. Y'all will have that review. But, she was just saying that moving away, you know, was a good deal for her. No, I already said that. But how basically these young bitches need to respect and bow down to the old bitches that have made a whole way for them, whatever, right? So then Jocelyn was like, well, you know, since I'm out here, y'all need to introduce me to some people, introduce me, you know, people in the industry, whoop de whoop, yada, yada, yada. Trick Daddy's like, well, you know, Prima Donna's out here. Baby, now I don't know none about Prima Donna. I don't, and that's not in a bad thing or not. I don't follow her. I don't know nothing about Prima Donna. This is my first time, really. I've heard her name before, but I don't know nothing about her. And I wasn't even aware that her and Jocelyn had some sort of beef going on back in the day. This damn Jocelyn Hernandez, baby, Jocelyn is back with them reeds, back like she never left. She was like, oh, you mean Prima Donna, like, the lady that sells waist trainers that's still big as a refrigerator? I said, oh, no, Jocelyn, not... Oh, Jocelyn don't give a shit. She don't give a shit. I said, damn, not a refrigerator. Briscoe's at the gym with his son, Lil Briscoe. His name is British. And I think that is such a handsome little name. That is so cute. They at the gym working out, having them a father-son moment. Briscoe say, you know, now that he's back, he was gone. You know what I'm saying? He back to be a father in his life. He said 3 months before he got, was getting ready to get out, his girl left his ass saying that she needs some space. Damn. You done rode with his ass for this whole 3 years? In the last 3 months? No, nigga, we in this shit for life now. Hell, that's crazy as hell. But he said, you know, she left his ass. So he's just trying to basically come back, make amends with his son, and, you know, be the real father, the real father, real man. He's supposed to be his son or whatever, right? They just having a little father son. I mean, it's cute or whatever. I like to see the fathers and the sons together. He's just, you know, he was reflecting on when he was in court, how the son was crying and how he called a couple times trying to check on him and how his son either wouldn't say nothing or would hang up on his ass. That's messed up. But, you know, he was pissed. He was a child. He don't know goddamn better. You the one making counterfeit notes. It ain't hollering at your old goddamn auntie and let me know you had these notes. Let me stop. Shut the fuck up. So Amada ends up meeting up with Julian, right? Because Amada is doing like this little photo shoot. She was cute, her little photo shoot with a little Gone with the Wind, fabulous with a little thigh-high boots or whatever. Julian looks shady. That nigga looks shifty. He look like the type of nigga, if you say, oh, baby, can you go take my car? Can you take my car to the car wash? Can you wash my car? Oh, yeah. This nigga finna take all the change out your console. He is. He looked real damn shifty like that. He either finna take all the change out the console of your car or all the change out your purse. That's what he looked like. A change stealing ass nigga. So she tells him that she done talked to Trina, and Trina done let her know the business, what's going on. She's just trying to find out from him, like, what's good, what's popping, what's going on. He admits that he got $300,000, but he's saying that that wasn't Trina money, that that was his money. He does admit that he was doing other deals and other stuff that he had going on. I mean, the whole shit just sounded shady. I was like, no, Mata. Watch this nigga. It's something that's not right about this dude. Amada's like, look here. I don't like this. Because my whole life depends on you. I don't like this. And the episode ended from there, y'all. I love me some of my niggas. Y'all, look here. I'm tired. I'm finna take my goddamn ass to bed. If it was anything that I missed, y'all already know. Drop it down below and let me know. We'll talk about it. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And Auntie Mo, we'll see y'all in the next video. Peace out.
What's going on, y'all? Look here. If you like this video, do me a favor. Give me a thumbs up, share this video, comment on this video, all of that good stuff. And if ain't nobody else told you today, I sure enough love you and I sure enough appreciate you.